meeting for our chapter, for our group. And this is all about deciding different sides of the sun and the moon. So when we say the different sides of the sun and the moon, this only means that there's certain different phenomena that involves within the motion of the sun and the moon. And one of which is the eclipses. But what are eclipses, right? Okay. So we're going to be discussing three major parts of this chapter. So first, what are eclipses? So what are eclipses? So why do eclipses? What is the reason why eclipses happen? And next, we're going to be dealing with the appearance of eclipses. So, how do we perceive the different types of eclipses? So, we will go now to the different types of eclipses right here. And the next part is the rarity of eclipses. So, when do eclipses happen? So, and how is it different with others? But with other celestial phenomena in our science? Okay? So first, let's go to the what are eclipses? So eclipses, made short. So this is just a phenomenon, or eclipses occur when the sun, the earth, and the moon align in the same line. Okay? So when the sun, earth, moon,
what's the number aligned to this in a straight line? When it is aligned, it is in a straight line.
So it pours in a line. So there are two types of eclipses, namely the solar eclipse and the lunar eclipse. They differ based on their arrangement. So let's go first to the solar eclipses. So solar eclipses happens mainly when the Earth is between the Sun and the Moon. And since the Earth is between the Sun and the Moon, So since the moon is between the sun and the earth, the moon casts a shadow on the earth. Okay, so it's clear. So I have a diagram, so in order for you to understand.
Wait a minute. What is your diagram a while ago? Go back to your next previous slide. Yeah.
So what is shown in the diagram is an example of the solar eclipse. So this is the view of how we view or how we see the solar eclipse from the Earth. So
what is this black one? Describe the black one. Describe the fringes.
Okay, so the black one that we see on the center, that's the moon that blocks the sun. And the fringes that there is, the light fringes around it, is the sun. So is it clear?
It's not the sun. It is only the...
The light of the sun.
Wala ko sa pinagdikit mo na yung moon dyan.
So it's the light coming from the sun. So this is the diagram, as I said a while ago. So the sun, the moon is in between the sun and the earth. Okay? So are there any questions so far? So let's now proceed to lunar eclipses.
So lunar eclipses is the diagram. Wait a minute again. You show the diagram, right? Oh. Asan dyan ang penumbra? Asan dyan ang umbra? You have to show to the diagram.
Antonio, kung ako kasi yung So the moon. So it's actually around. So in lunar eclipses, the Earth is between the part, so only a portion of the celestial body, either the Earth or the Moon, na nagka-cast ng shadow on the other. And that's ayun naman po, by the way around, pag sabi natin total, so pag total, ibig sabihin, the entire celestial body covers or blocks the view of the other body. Okay? So it's either the sun or the moon that covers the other one. Okay? So let's first do the different types of
it is the sun or the moon that covers the what?
It's either the Earth or the Moon that covers the other one.
Covers
the sun.
Or hinders the sun. Sabi mo kanina, the sun and the moon. Kaya dito pag antok-antok ako, hindi ko maririnig yung sinasabi niyo. Hindi alam na ang yan. Walang nag-re-react eh.
So yeah. So we have here the different types of solar eclipses. So we have the total solar eclipse, the partial solar eclipse, and the annular solar eclipse. So as you may see in the diagrams that is presented here, is there are different nakakaiba yung mga features of Earth or how they are viewed from Earth. Okay, so let's first go to the total solar eclipse. So, papalit po. So, since total, ito sa bilid mo. Pero ano itong nagpo-cover ng mo? So, it only means that the moon covers or enters or blocks the view of the sun from the Earth. Okay? So, kapag mo ba? Okay. And since nakakover nga ng entire view ng moon, yung sun, ang magiging mas po nito is nagiging total darkness or mas nagiging dark yung area kung saan meron total solar eclipse. Okay? So, yun nga. So, while ago, so, sabi nga, dapat ina direct line. Ina-screen pa. Okay? So, this, so ito. So, ano na yung pinakita natin ng mga yun. So, nakita niya naman, in the diagrams. So, yun ang nakita niya. Yung black, dahil na yung pinakita. So, that is the blue. While the fringes, where's the light coming from? So, diba, diba? So, let's proceed to the next one. So, kung meron total, syempre meron partial. So, pag partial solar eclipse naman, only a part or a portion of the moon covers the sun. So, yeah. So, as right here, when you say on this picture, so, yun na dito yung parang present type, parang dito yung present, diba? So, yung yellow orange na present din, so that's the sun. While this one, so this area na yun, ito na yun yung moon. Ito na cover dun sa view natin from sa off the sun. So, nakuha po ba? So, only a part of the moon covers the sun. Covers the view of the sun. So, yeah. So, ito yung so, paano na nakakaroon or bakit nakakaroon ng partial result, partial eclipse and total eclipse. So, dito na kayo papasok yung concept na umbra and umbra. So, kapag sinabi natin umbra, so I have a question personally. Based on the diagram, what do you think is the area? So, this is the area where this is the umbra, while this one is the penumbra. Okay, so let's look at the diagram. So, what do you think is the, where is the area that has the darkest area or darkest shadow? Para na yung fringes, diba? Para nagtakip lang tayo ng about it. Parang yung somebody alam yung utang natin sa sun, diba? Parang alam lang namin na yung place. Pero dito, sa annular, it is imperfect or almost living like structure. So, nakuha ba? It is because that yung distance ng moon from the earth is mas malayo. Okay, nakuha ba? So, yun. So, mas malayo na yun. It is made sure, so ano pinagkaya na ito? So usually, ito, this is the view before an annular solar eclipse occurred. So di ba nakikita niyo parang crescent like the moon and sa gilid? And the one in the center is syempre yung mismong annular solar eclipse na. And the third one is yung after na magpas ng moon sa sun. Ay, na moon from sun. Yeah. So, yeah. So dito na lang magpas ko na, balikan natin ulit sa umbra and penumbra. So, sa umbra, so this is the solar shadow that casts on the Earth. So, I think it's the dark center. Diba sabi nga natin yung business diagram, ano mas dark? Yung umbra o yung penumbra? Oh, yung umbra. So, next one dito, penumbra, ito yung mas malaki, the larger shadow na nagka-cast from, or the shadow na nagka-cast outside the umbra. Okay? So, ito yung lagay ng pako dito. Ayan. So, sabi nga natin, di ba, umbra, mas darker ang shadow na nakikinig sa kesa sa penumbra. So, therefore, okay, so, tignan natin this. So, pwede na sabi natin dito na kapag umbra, dito nagkakaroon ng total eclipses. And then, kapag penumbra, since nakikinig lang yung shadow na nakikinig, so, dito naman natin yung view ang partial eclipses. So, nakuha ko ba? Okay, how about the lunar eclipse? Still, in the lunar eclipses, we still have three different types. So, the usual total lunar eclipse, the partial lunar eclipse, and the penumbral lunar eclipse. So, dito naman, in discussing lunar eclipse, di ba? Okay, recala. In lunar eclipse, ano, what is in between the sun and the moon? And the sun and the moon. What is in between the sun and the moon? So, therefore, yung Earth yung nagkakas ng shadow sa moon. Kaya, what we see on the moon, where the moon, how do we perceive the moon during the lunar eclipse? So, ito na yung it's because that yung area ng Earth, the specific area of the Earth, hindi nakita na yung nakaka-view na yun, yung lunar eclipse. So, maliwanag ko pa para yung see. So, para sa hindi na natin sa isa. Okay, so ito yung nakakawin sa the dark or the red moon na tinatawag natin. So, the total lunar eclipse. So, how, where, or when does it occur? So, it occurs when the moon and the sun are in the opposite exact place and 1/8 towards each other. And, bakit naging red? So, di ba naging red, di ba? Okay, so na natin na-associate pa lang yung term na red moon or yung bloody moon sa mga fiction. Sa ano na sa secret na characters dito. So, yung mga vampires, diba? Yung sa Twilight, diba? Yung mga series. So, meron yung, diba meron na sa Twilight sa akin yung moon na moon, diba? So, ito yung ibig sabihin ko ito. It's because that, okay, bakit nangyayin rin? It's because that the Earth has its atmosphere. So, na-filter out yung most of the blue light from lalo, kaya namagin natin dito as red yung moon. Okay, so may tanong ko ba about moon? Okay, so let's proceed. So next one. So partial lunar eclipse. So since partial na, therefore only a part of the Earth's shadows cast on the moon. So it only happens when only a part of the Earth's shadows cast on the moon. And Earth's shadows appears very dark on the side of the moon.
Ano yung naka-picture na yan?
So this is my example of the partial lunar eclipse.
And what is that in the picture? What is that in the picture?
So this is the moon. Okay, so this is the view of the moon, during a partial lunar eclipse. So okay, if you will look at the picture, so it's just like a simple crescent face of the moon. So either you want to see or you really crescent. But the thing is, yun na dito yung parang dark area na ito. So this is the know that lunar eclipse. So when does this happen? So this only happens when the moon passes through the penumbral shadow of the Earth. So it is very hindi masyadong observable to the naked eye. So observe ito para mas makita niyo. Okay, so we have here the before the penumbral lunar eclipse. So what piece is this? The piece ng moon tuktok. Okay, so sa full moon, di ba? And this